Bonjour tout le monde, merci pour ça et merci Marie-Claude pour l'introduction. Je sais que ce n'est pas toujours un défi de demander à une politicienne de parler un petit peu plus, but I appreciate you stretching out a little bit while I race down the stairs to get here. Now you probably don't know this, but Marie-Claude sits right beside me at the cabinet table. Which means whenever an issue comes up regarding agriculture or regarding rural families or regarding just about anything that matters to you, she is right there leaning in, reminding me of the things that matter most to the community across the country. And I really, really have to say, you are all lucky to have her in your corner, and I'm grateful to have her fighting for you every day. Thank you for everything you do, Marie-Claude. Glad to be here as well with MPs Cody Blois and Francis Drouin, the Parliamentary Secretary. And I want to also begin by taking a moment to thank Mary Robinson for her leadership as President of the Canadian Federation of Agriculture. Mary, you've led this organization through an unprecedented 4 years, everything from the pandemic to potato wart, I know that's something you were aware of, to problems with supply chains and global food insecurity. I want to welcome Keith Currie to the role, and our government looks forward to working with you, Keith. Before I begin, I also want to celebrate that earlier today, alongside the Government of Saskatchewan, we announced that families in Saskatchewan will have $10 a day childcare starting next month, saving them up to an average of $573 a month per child compared to 2 years ago. I know a lot of you grew up on and run family farms, so you know how important it is to be there for families through thick and thin, and we will, of course, keep up that work. To the farmers, producers, farm groups, co-ops, and more who make up the Canadian Federation of Agriculture, thank you for having me here today, and thank you for everything that you do. You grow the crops and raise the livestock that feed Canada and feed the world. Across Canada this morning, people are fueling their days with yogurt from Quebec dairy farmers, fruit from BC orchards, egg from Ontario poultry farmers, and kids across the country are packing their lunch boxes with sandwiches that have bread made with prairie grains, vegetables from a local greenhouse, and roast beef from an Alberta cattle ranch. This is some of the best food in the world, and it's produced by you, the farmers of Canada. Most of you on family farms that have been around for generations. Il y a deux semaines, j'ai participé à une discussion publique avec l'Union des producteurs agricoles à Longueuil, où j'ai entendu les points de vue des agriculteurs et des producteurs québécois. Des gens comme Stéphane, un producteur laitier de Lanaudière, qui s'inquiète de la relève pour sa ferme familiale. Catherine, une acéricultrice et productrice maraîchère qui doit composer avec des pénuries de main-d'œuvre. Daniel, un producteur de céréales qui a du mal à assumer les coûts de fonctionnement de sa ferme. Les agriculteurs font face à des défis bien réels et on veut tous être là avec vous. On veut être là pour que vous puissiez continuer de produire les aliments de qualité tout en restant résilient. Climate change is an increasingly urgent issue for farmers. You are on the front lines. When extreme weather strikes, it hits your bottom lines directly. Hurricane Fiona damaged barns, orchards, and fields, destroying crops and killing cattle. PEI lost an estimated third of its fruit trees. That's a shocking number. Au cours des dernières années, vous avez subi des sécheresses, des inondations et des feux de forêt. On a investi près d'$1 milliard pour aider le secteur à atténuer les conséquences des changements climatiques et à réduire les émissions. Mais les saisons de croissance qui changent, les épisodes de sécheresse et d'inondations qui se multiplient, vous poussent à vous adapter. Les agriculteurs sont aux premières lignes des changements climatiques, mais ils sont aussi des leaders quand vient le temps de trouver des solutions. On n'a qu'à penser à des pratiques comme l'implantation de brise-vent et de cultures couvre-sol. Vous rendez vos fermes plus efficaces et productives en adaptant la gérance des nutriments 4B et en utilisant des technologies de précision comme le GPS et les drones. Pour vous épauler dans votre travail, on fait des investissements majeurs dans des programmes comme le Fonds d'action à la ferme pour le climat, solutions agricoles pour le climat et le programme des technologies propres en agriculture. Notre but, c'est d'aider les agriculteurs, les scientifiques et les groupes autochtones à élaborer et adopter des pratiques de gestion durable. On veut tous la même chose, de l'air pur, de l'eau propre, un sol et des troupeaux en santé et de l'abondance pour des années et des décennies à venir. You guys are worried about climate change and a whole lot of other things. On top of that, there's a lot of disinformation and misinformation you may be reading online that's adding to your worries. I was at a town hall in Langley, BC just last Thursday, where Cade asked me why we were, quote, mandating a 30% reduction in fertilizer. I want to be as clear with you as I was with him. We are consulting with farmers in the industry about a voluntary, not mandatory, reduction in emissions from fertilizers, not in use of fertilizers. I've heard directly from you that finding ways to use fertilizer more efficiently is important, both for the sustainability and resilience of our environment and of your bottom lines. La durabilité, c'est aussi la durabilité financière. On sait que les agriculteurs font face à des réalités différentes de celles de bien d'autres Canadiens. C'est pourquoi on vient d'annoncer le partenariat canadien pour une agriculture durable, conclu avec l'ensemble des provinces et des territoires, qui va entrer en vigueur le 1er avril. C'est un investissement de 3,5 milliards de dollars. C'est une augmentation de 25 % par rapport au dernier partenariat, et il a été élaboré en fonction de priorités que vous avez exprimées. Après les coupures du gouvernement précédent, on a renforcé les programmes de gestion des risques de l'entreprise pour vous offrir une meilleure couverture en cas de difficulté. We're investing to help you adopt technologies and practices that are not just good for the environment, but also good for your bottom line. Our price on pollution is in place to reduce emissions and fight climate change, and it puts money back in Canadians' pockets, including farmers, in places that use the federal system. That's why, for farmers specifically, we've exempted gasoline and diesel for farm use from pollution pricing. And for eligible farms in backstop jurisdictions, we've brought in tax credits for things like propane and natural gas use. In addition, families that live in rural communities, like farm families, get a 10% top-up to their climate action incentive payments that come in 4 times a year. We've also provided funding to help farmers invest in clean technologies that reduce your energy costs, like helping farmers purchase more efficient grain dryers. But there's also an ongoing reality around high global inflation and interest rates that are hitting you all hard. Supply chain disruptions and Putin's illegal war have driven up the price of essential inputs. Most concerningly, global food prices went up when Russia weaponized food and prevented the export of grain that vulnerable countries were relying on. It was a cruelty on an unfathomable scale and was more evidence of just how essential farmers' contributions are. Canada is doing its part to support farmers in Ukraine, but we know this global situation is affecting Canadian farmers too. Simply put, farming is getting more expensive. While programs like the Advanced Payments Program provide low and interest-free loans so you can afford things like fuel, fertilizer, and seed. And I want to note that we raised the interest-free limit to $250,000 for last year and this year. I've heard your concerns, and our government is constantly looking at more ways we can keep being there for you. We offer generous programs, and we want to make sure that they're responding to the needs of smaller family farms and younger farmers as well. The previous government's track record on agriculture is one of budget cuts, but we believe in supporting you, not taking you for granted, and that's why we'll keep investing in agriculture. On sait que le meilleur moyen d'assurer la réussite à long terme des agriculteurs canadiens est d'aider vos entreprises à prospérer. Il vous faut plus de travailleurs pour faire croître vos entreprises. C'est pour ça qu'on a haussé nos cibles d'immigration et qu'on étend les permis de travail aux membres de la famille des travailleurs étrangers temporaires. et on écoute vos idées sur la façon d'éliminer les pénuries de main-d'œuvre. On bâtit également des chaînes d'approvisionnement résilientes avec des réseaux routiers, ferroviaires et portuaires qui permettent de transporter vos produits vers les marchés à travers le Canada et partout dans le monde. We have free trade agreements with 51 countries, representing nearly two-thirds of global GDP. And in 2022, agriculture and agri-food exports reached a record high of almost $93 billion, shattering our target of $75 billion by 2025, years ahead of schedule. To build on this momentum, as part of our Indo-Pacific strategy, we're opening our first ever agriculture and agri-food office in Asia. As Asian populations and economies grow, they'll need more Canadian canola, Canadian pork, and all kinds of high-quality Canadian products. And we're taking action to make sure Canada remains a supplier of choice. We want to support the stability of the sector here at home as well. Supply management is a guarantee of quality and a guarantee of stability for the next generation. It's a system that has worked very well for over 40 years and that will continue to work. When we renegotiated NAFTA, we got a good deal for the entire Canadian economy. But because the president was specifically targeting dairy farmers in particular, we had to compensate producers in the supply management sectors to get the right deal. We have now delivered full and fair compensation to dairy, egg, and poultry farmers, and I promise that Canadians that never again will Canada's supply management system be up for negotiation in trade deals. There's a bill in the House of Commons right now that would enshrine this into law and ensure future governments respect this promise. Supply management is important not only for dairy farmers, but for the entire agricultural community because it provides stability that their communities and the sector more broadly can count on. As farmers, you work the land, you raise the animals, you feed Canada, you feed the world. You love what you do. It's tough work and it's essential work. And every Canadian is grateful. We've seen over the past years, through the pandemic, through the anxieties around supply chains, just how, unfortunately, too many of us take for granted the hard work that you do every single day. Canadians are beginning to understand more than ever before how important it is to be able to rely on local, high-quality Canadian producers of the food that they rely on, of the goods they want to support their families with, of how we build a stronger economy and a stronger future for everyone. Ça prend plus d'agriculteurs. Il faut que la prochaine génération soit là pour continuer à produire les aliments de qualité qui font la réputation du Canada. Il faut qu'il y ait un bon avenir pour la relève. So now I'm looking forward to opening it up and hearing from all of you. Because as leaders, it's important to have a dialogue with the people that we choose to serve. So we can be there with what you need for today and into the future. To strengthen our family farms and build a stronger, more resilient, more inclusive agricultural sector as a vibrant part of an economy that works for all Canadians.